Penn joins Philadelphia as fireworks, chaos, and celebrations erupt across the city. Euphoria spread across the wet streets of Philadelphia last night as the clock on the Super Bowl ran down, and it became clear that the Philadelphia Eagles had beaten the New England Patriots 41-33 in Minnesota. Penn students, staff, and faculty joined thousands of Philadelphians in every corner of the city as they celebrated the team's first-ever Super Bowl win. Minutes after the game ended, Penn students were seen charging down Spruce Street in the rain, yelling "Go Eagles!" Cars heading into Center City were honking nonstop as firecrackers were set off on Broad Street, and throngs of people in green marched down Market Street waving Eagles flags and chanting, "We all we got! We all we need!" Swarms of Philadelphia police attempted to control the crowd as it spread across the city, but to little avail. Even as garbage trucks were used for crowd control, fans in Eagles jerseys were seen climbing traffic poles, moving vehicles and buildings in various states of undress. By midnight, cars had been turned over and vandalized, and multiple traffic poles outside City Hall had been taken down by fans. Euphoria spread across the wet streets of Philadelphia last night as the clock on the Super Bowl ran down, and it became clear that the Philadelphia Eagles had beaten the New England Patriots 41-33 in Minnesota. Penn students, staff, and faculty joined thousands of Philadelphians in every corner of the city as they celebrated the team's first-ever Super Bowl win. Minutes after the game ended, Penn students were seen charging down Spruce Street in the rain, yelling "Go Eagles!" Cars heading into Center City were honking nonstop as firecrackers were set off on Broad Street, and throngs of people in green marched down Market Street waving Eagles flags and chanting, "We all we got! We all we need!" Swarms of Philadelphia police attempted to control the crowd as it spread across the city, but to little avail. Even as garbage trucks were used for crowd control, fans in Eagles jerseys were seen climbing traffic poles, moving vehicles and buildings in various states of undress. By midnight, cars had been turned over and vandalized, and multiple traffic poles outside City Hall had been taken down by fans. College freshman Anna Berenbaum agreed, "This is the first time they've won, and I'm a freshman. This will never happen again in our 4 years. We're just here to live life. It's just so amazing. You want to be part of the history," said Wharton senior Isabella Peralta, who is from Costa Rica. "Where we come from, Latin America, it's super big to go down to the streets and see everybody united for a cause, so it's pretty cool to be here now and go through the same thing here. And it's our senior year, so it's 10 times cooler." But some students who traveled down to Center City said the excitement of the situation escalated too quickly. College sophomore Kyla Helm said she saw people running up and down the road, people climbing walls, people climbing lampposts. She added, "It's just really crazy." Helm said she decided to return to campus once she witnessed a group of people flip over a car. "A bunch of people flipped a car, and there were three or four people including myself yelling stop, and everyone else just watched and cheered them as they defaced someone's property, which is absolutely insane," she said. After finishing 7-9 for the past two seasons, the Eagles played successfully this past season to finish 13-3. The last time the team reached the Super Bowl was 2004, when it lost to none other than the Patriots. Even before the start of the game, city officials had been making preparations for the crowds. Over 50 police officers were stationed along Broad Street, which was closed from City Hall to Pine Street.